This weekend, I'm going for a road trip with two little kids. I want to make sure that they're entertained throughout the road trip and also well fed. So I'm preparing a snack box with few tidbits here and there. Let me show you what all I'm going to make today. Let's start with the sweetest part of the snack box. I'm making some chocolate cookie sandwiches. I have some chocolate chip cookies over here. I'm going to apply a little bit of peanut butter to this. You can also use the crunchy kind if you like. Making peanut butter at home is extremely simple. If you want to make it at home, check out the link in the description box below. Once all the sandwiches are ready, we're going to dip them in chocolate. Although you can have these sandwiches on their own, you can also dip them in chocolate of your choice. I'm using dark chocolate today, but this is the sweet kind. Just dunk half of the cookie and place it on a butter paper so that it's easy to pick up and place in the snack box. Also, this recipe is so simple to make, you can make it with any biscuit of your choice. Within 5 minutes, the chocolate sets on its own and you can take it off the butter paper and set it aside. You can make this a couple of days in advance and enjoy it as soon as you make it. Now that our sweet snack is ready, let's move on to something crunchy that can also be stored for up to a week. I'm making some pizza flavored makhana. I'm going to start roasting the makhana on low flame. When you roast the makhana on high flame, what happens is it stays crunchy for a while and becomes soft again. So make sure to do it on low flame. The makhana has turned nice and crunchy. It has a beautiful golden brown color on it. Place the makhana on one side, turn off the flame. Add a little bit of oil on the other side. I'm going to add in some pizza seasoning and a little bit of salt. And as soon as it starts sizzling, I'm going to mix in the makhana. This step ensures that the makhana is properly seasoned with all these spices. Take it out in a bowl. Let it cool completely. This should take about 5 minutes. Now it's time to make a savory and fun snack. I'm making a corn and capsicum toast. So I'm starting with one capsicum that has been chopped, 4 tablespoons of corn, salt, pizza seasoning, chili flakes, 1.5 tablespoons of ketchup. I'm going to give this a quick mix. I'm using corn and capsicum today for the toast because they travel really well and don't go bad during the journey. Our filling is now ready. Let's assemble it on our toast. Let's start by toasting one side of the bread with a little bit of butter. This is an extra step that I take to ensure that the bread doesn't go soggy, adding a little bit of butter on the other side as well. One side of the bread is lightly toasted. I'm going to flip it over and turn down the flame. I'm going to add in the mixture that we just made. Use as much as you like. It's very important that the cheese is added on top so that all the toppings stay in place during traveling. Now I'm going to cover and cook this till the cheese has melted completely. Let's check on it. Let's have a look at the bottom. Looks nice and crunchy and crispy. Take it off on a plate. I'm going to cut this diagonally from both sides. And our mini capsicum and corn toast is ready to go into our snack box. 3 of our snacks are ready to go. Now I'm going to make something absolutely filling. This is a batter which is very universal. You can make chilas out of them or appe or use it in any form that you like. Let's start by preparing the batter. This is 1/4 cup of whole wheat flour, 1/3 cup of chickpea flour, 2 tablespoons of rice flour, salt to taste, some red chili flakes, 1/2 teaspoon red chili powder, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 clove of garlic, 1/2 capsicum, 1 chopped onion as well, grated potato. Using a fork, I'm going to mix this together. It's very important to mix it first and then add water as required. I'm going to add in 3 tablespoons at a time. When you add water, the vegetables will also start releasing their moisture. And here we have a nice thick batter ready with us. Before we start making the appe, I'm going to add a pinch of fruit salt to make sure they are nice and soft. And quickly going to mix it. Our batter is ready. While the appe pan is heating up, I'm going to grease it with a little bit of oil using a brush. You can also use ghee here. Now we're going to spoon in the batter into our appe mold. do this on low flame so that all the vegetables that we have used are cooked properly. As mentioned earlier, you can use any flour of your choice. You can also make this gluten-free by adding in oats flour, jawar flour or bajra flour. Now that the mold has been filled completely, I'm going to cover it and let it cook. Let's have a look inside. The top has dried out properly. I'm going to turn it upside down and cook it from the other side as well. Using a butter knife, I'm just going to flip it. Our mini chila bites are now ready. I'm going to use a toothpick and stack two at a time so that it's easy to eat while traveling. It's been 5 minutes. The makhana is now cold, so I'm going to add it to an airtight container. All our little snacks are ready to go in our snack box now. Let me start by packing our toast. My snack box is ready to go and I'm off to my road trip. But you can also make these individual snacks for breakfast or evening. You're going to definitely love it. Give these recipes a try and let me know how they turn out. This is Chef Bhumika signing off from Rajshree Foods.